All right, Mr. D, we talk a lot about herbicides. So let's give the folks herbicide basics and some terms involved as well.
That's right. And let's just start out by saying, you know, all herbicides are pesticides, but not all pesticides are herbicides.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
Okay. And we'll, you know, all Volkswagens are cars, but not all cars are Volkswagens, right?
We got
so, so herbicide is anything that'll kill a plant. And there are several different herbicides out there. We have pre-emergent herbicides that will actually prevent a weed from coming up, or when it comes up, it'll kill it in the process of it germinating and coming up. And then there are post-emergent herbicides, and those are the herbicides that you apply to weeds or to plants to kill that are already up and growing. A couple of examples of pre-emergent herbicides would be prial-pendimethalin or treflan, or their examples of pre-emergent herbicides that you put out there early, usually earlier in the year, or and some of the pre-emergent herbicides for long lawns you'll put out in the fall to take care of the winter weeds and things like that. Post-emergent herbicides are the ones that, you know, you got weeds growing out there and you go out there and you try to kill them. Glyphosate Roundup is an example of a post-emergent herbicide. Cethoxidim is another. And there are a lot of there are probably more post-emergent herbicides out there than there are pre-emergent herbicides. It's good to use both of them to get the best results. If you use a combination of pre- and post-emergent herbicides, you'll probably do a better job. There are contact herbicides that kill a plant when you spray it on there. Gramoxone is an example of a contact herbicide that you know you can cover half of a leaf and spray half of it with gramoxone, and that half of the leaf that you spray will die, and the other half that you cover will not. Then there are systemic herbicides, and these are herbicides that are taken up by the green tissue of the plant and translocates throughout the plant and will kill the entire plant. Glyphosate is an example of a systemic herbicide. Trade names are Roundup is a trade name, Post is a trade name, and the active ingredient of Roundup is glyphosate, and the active ingredient of Post is cethoxidim. And many times there are a lot of different trade names for one active ingredient. I mean, glyphosate, there are probably hundreds of products out there
that
have glyphosate.
Plenty of generics.
Same thing with cethoxidim. There are a lot of different trade names. Vantage is another example of a trade name of cethoxidim. Roundup is even, it's a Monsanto product, but now there's a Roundup that doesn't have glyphosate in it.
Yeah, so for lawns,
yeah. Yeah, so you've got to be careful. You've got to read the label. Right. It's very important with any of the herbicides, you read the label. There are different categories of toxicity with herbicides, and some of them are pretty toxic to humans if you ingest them. Some of them are toxic if you ingest them, and they're not toxic dermally. Some of them are toxic dermally. You get them on your skin and it can hurt you. Again, the label will explain that. Let me give you an idea of the difference in the toxicity levels of some of the herbicides here. Here we are. There are only a couple of highly toxic herbicides that are out there on the market, and I'm not sure that they are still on the market. Bapam was a soil, the term, it was a soil sterilant for nematodes that you put in the ground to basically control nematodes. And I'm not sure Vapam is still on the market.
Yeah, I didn't hear it.
The active ingredient is methem. Sodium arsenate is another one that we used to use to control insects and cotton. And I don't think that's on the market anymore.
No.
But those are highly toxic herbicides. And highly toxic herbicides on the label will have a signal word. There are signal words that very briefly describe how toxic a herbicide is and other pesticides also. But danger/poison with skull and crossbones, that is the most toxic of the herbicide. If you see that, you know, lock it away somewhere. And you probably can't buy it as a homeowner unless you have a restricted use permit.
Right.
Or
it would mostly just be the issue of people happening upon something in an old building or something, and that's where they'd need to be careful.
If you see a skull and crossbones, you just kind of stay away from it. It's probably not a pirate ship.
No.
There are moderately toxic herbicides, and the signal word for that is warning.
Okay.
And the difference between highly toxic and moderately toxic is the lethal dose of a highly toxic herbicide, or LD50, is a lethal dose required to kill 50% of the animals in the population. Mm-hmm. It's probably mostly rats.
Right.
We don't check it with humans. But highly toxic is less than 50, and will kill half of the rats in the population. You know, if you got 50 rats out there, it should kill 25 of those rats.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Moderately toxic herbicides, it's 50 to 500.
Okay.
And examples of things that you and I are around every day that have that level of toxicity are caffeine. If you have that much caffeine, gasoline, kerosene.
Right. Know those.
Some herbicides are Avenge, Aquathol. Some aquatic herbicides carry that much toxicity, to mammalian toxicity. But mammalian toxicity is different from fish and organisms. So some of the things are more toxic to us than they are to aquatic organisms. Slightly toxic herbicides, and there are a lot more of those than there are of the highly toxics. The LD50 for them is 500 to 5,000 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. And signal word on the label will just be caution.
Mm-hmm.
So be careful. Probable lethal dose for a 150-pound person is 1 ounce to 1 pint or 1 pound. If you ingest it,
right?
So, I mean, I try to avoid eating most of the time.
Right. Infrequent.
But aspirin is something that carries that same lethal dose designation. Table salt carries that same lethal designation. But herbicides, Abacigran, Command, 2,4-D, 2,4-DB, Cethoxidem, Post, mentioned that. Dicamba carries that same level of toxicity. Vinegar is another something on our tables that carries that same. It's acetic
acid. Which often
comes
up when we talk about what are some potentially organic herbicides.
Right.
And
vinegar
is
the first thing that comes up.
Acetic acid. So, yeah. Then almost non-toxic herbicides, they carry LD50 of greater than 5,000 milligrams per kilogram body weight. Lethal dose of almost non-toxic herbicide for a 150-pound person is more than 1 pint or 1 pound.
Mm.
That's a pretty full meal.
That's a lot.
Roundup, glyphosate, Touchdown, Rodeo, or a couple other products have glyphosate in them. Arsenal, Chopper, Scepter, Pursuit. There's this page of Treflan, Princep. So most of the herbicides that you can buy on the shelf fit within the almost non-toxic, most of them are in that category.
Right, because most of those are going to contain 2,4-D, for the most part, or dicamba.
Right,
which would be your post-emerge herbicides.
But one thing I want to mention, in this last list that I listed, they were almost non-toxic. I kind of scanned over that. And I saw two herbicides in there that are restricted use pesticides. But it's not because of their mammalian toxicity, it's because that they will very easily go off site.
Right.
If get rain right after you put it out, can kill desirable plants.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. But a lot of different herbicides out there. Just read the label. That's the take home point. Read and follow the label.
Thank you, Mr. Diaz. Good stuff. Read and follow the label, folks. Appreciate that, Mr. D.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.